Good morning. My name is Engineer Piyush Pandey. Welcome to today's session of Motivational Skills. And the topic for today's discussion is, what is the difference between verbal and non-verbal communication? Ladies and gentlemen, we have two categories of communication. One is verbal communication and another one is non-verbal communication. Now, what is the difference between the two? We often confuse that verbal communication is a spoken form of communication and non-verbal communication is gestural form of communication. Now that's true, very true, but here is a bit misconception. Let me clarify that what is the misconception regarding verbal communication skills. Ladies and gentlemen, the logical definition of verbal communication is communication by the mode of any language. When we communicate to some other person by the help of some language, that is known as verbal communication. And when we don't use any language, we communicate with hand movements and body movements and other such gestures, that is known as non-verbal communication. So verbal communication is logically communication by the mode of any language. Now, when we are communicating by the mode of any language, we can communicate in two ways. We can use a language in written form and we can use a language in oral form also. That's why verbal communication has two parts, oral communication and written communication. In oral communication, we do communication by speaking. Speaking is known as oral communication. Whatever language we are using, if we are using it in spoken form, it is known as oral communication. And when we are using the same language in written form, We are explaining different things to people by writing, that is known as written communication. So, verbal communication has two parts, oral and written. Similarly, non-verbal communication also has two parts. As I have already explained, non-verbal communication is communication by hand movements and body gestures by not using any kind of language in spoken or written form. Similarly, non-verbal communication also has two parts. Non-verbal communication, body language and paralanguage, and second is non-verbal communication, object language and sign language. I would like to repeat, first is non-verbal communication, body language and paralanguage, second is non-verbal communication, object language and sign language. First we will discuss non-verbal communication, body language and paralanguage. How we sit, how we stand, how we behave, how we make eye contact, whatever body movements are there without making a single word, that is known as body language. What your body says, what your eye movements say, what your hand movements say, what your overall body structure says while you are communicating to someone without using a single word, that is known as body language. And paralanguage is how you verbalize something. When you are speaking, you speak in a different way and the manner in which you speak, it gives different types of indication to the other person. That is known as paralanguage. Paralanguage means we can use our spoken form in different ways in order to convey different type of meanings. For example, if I have to say that I will not go Delhi today. If I am just saying this to someone, just to clarify his doubt, I will say, I will not go to Delhi today. And if I am feeling very sad, I will say it in a different way. I will not go to Delhi today. Something. Not going. Fine. So that's a different way of saying something. One is a straightforward way and one is the way when I am sad, I am not feeling good. And the third way is, I don't want to go to Delhi and someone is compelling me. I will be more forceful. How dare you? I will not go to Delhi today. So, see the difference. These are the three different sentences. I explained them in three different methods. This is known as paralanguage. How you actually verbalize something, it conveys a different meaning related to a particular thing. That is known as paralanguage. Object language and body language and paralanguage. And the another category of non-verbal communication is object language and sign language. I have made a video yesterday in which I have explained object language and paralanguage very clearly. There are so many things around us, ladies and gentlemen, that we see, and after seeing those things, we clearly understand that what they are indicating. For example, traffic signal light. When it is green, we understand that we have to move. When it is red, we understand that we have to stop. Now the traffic light is not speaking that, okay, now I am red, please stop. Now I am green, please move ahead. Now I am yellow, please be ready, you are about to move. The traffic light is not speaking anything, still we are able to understand that what these colors, different colors indicated by the street light, they convey what particular message. So this is known as sign language and object language. By looking at the ambulance symbol, you can very well analyze that this vehicle is known as ambulance. It has a different symbol. So these are certain things which don't need to convey their identity in a spoken form. There are certain symbols, there are certain indications, and while looking at these symbols and indications, we can very well understand that what they want to convey, what message they want to convey. So ladies and gentlemen, this is the major difference between verbal communication and non-verbal communication. If we understand all these differences thoroughly, it is 100% sure that we will utilize both these types of communication in a perfect way to accomplish whatever we want to accomplish in our organization successfully. So that's all for today, ladies and gentlemen. I hope that you loved my today's video. Please subscribe my channel, ER Piyush Pandey, Trainer BTech MBA, and please press the bell icon for constant updates. Thank you very much. Have a great day.